Let's talk about database performance. Database performance in MongoDB is driven by pretty much the same thing that every database is driven by, which is, are you going to use an index to resolve your query or not? So this may be review for a lot of you, but I want to take you through the basics of indexing and what it is and why it's so effective. If you look at MongoDB or any other database, it will store its data in these large files on disk. There's no particular order for the documents on the disk. They can be anywhere in a database file. If you want to pull out a particular document, you do a query. Now, what the database is going to have to do by default is scan through the entire collection to find the data. This is called a table scan in relational databases and a collection scan in MongoDB. It is death to your performance. If the data set is large, it'll be extremely slow. So instead, what we do is we create an index, or maybe more than one index. So how does indexing work? Well, it's actually pretty straightforward. If something is ordered, like for instance, this list of hashtags, even if it's very long, it's very quick to find something in the list because we can use binary search to do it. So finding something in a sorted list is really quick. Now to create an index, we want to specify a key. An index is simply an ordered list of keys. Now, we don't actually keep them linearly ordered like this in MongoDB. We use something called a B-tree. But conceptually, you could imagine it looking like this. It's a perfectly reasonable conceptual model. And if I'm looking for, let's say, Lucero, I can quickly search, find the item, and then have a pointer to the actual document or documents inside the collection that have this hashtag associated with them. So this picture actually represents an index that is composed of just hashtags. So we're using a single field as the basis for our index. But this is just a special case of the more general idea of indexes in MongoDB. In MongoDB, indexes are ordered lists of keys. You can have just one, as we saw in the previous example, or we could do something like this and construct an index out of three keys. Let's say, for example, the hashtag, the date on which a tweet was created, and the username of the person creating the tweet. The order is important here. Because conceptually, the way the index is built is that the hashtag will be at the top. So here are my hashtags, Colin Hay, Lucero, and then Steve Earle near the end of my index. And then within this, so let's say Colin Hay is conceptually here. For all of those items, we'll have dates as the second level of our index. And what we're going to do within the Colin Hay portion of the index is sort these by order of date. So the documents then that are identified down to this level of date are first identified by the hashtag Colin Hay and then sorted based on their date of creation. And then finally, within each date, so for each day on which a tweet was created with the hashtag Colin Hay, we're going to have the usernames of all of those users, and those then will be sorted as well. So if you provide me just the hashtag, I can go into the index and find all the, let's say, Luceros in this case. And if you prefer to also provide me the date, then I can break it down and find all the Lucero tweets on that particular day. At the very bottom of this, of course, is going to be pointers to the actual data. Now, in order for MongoDB to utilize an index, you have to give it a leftmost set of items. So you can give it just the hashtag, or you can give it just the hashtag and the date, or the hashtag, the date, and the username. For this particular index, if you provide me just the date, I can't do much really with the index because the date is down here at this level. So to use an index, I need to start at the top. And this is true whether or not I'm doing a query or I'm doing an update or I'm doing a sort, because sorts also will use an index to sort their values. So for instance, if I pull a bunch of data out of the collection and want to sort it by hashtag, with MongoDB, I can use this index to do the sorting. Now, one other point I want to make is that every time you want to insert something into the database, this index would need to be updated. And that updating is going to take some time. So we use indexes to make reads faster, but writes become a little bit slower if you have an index because the index needs to be updated. So you need to take that into consideration when you're thinking about what indexes you might want for your particular application. Indexes are not costless. They take space on disk. They also take time to keep updated. So you don't want to have an index on every single possible way you're going to query the collection. You instead want to have an index on the ways you're most likely to query the collection.